So yeah, let's start out with some pretty non-public radio music.
At the next light, turn left.
From 1999, that's the band Slipknot. That's a song called Wait and Bleed. That's Corey Taylor on the lead vocals there. Corey and Slipknot had that big hit in sort of the heavy metal circles, and then they became one of the most important and influential and like long-lasting bands in what we'll call like the heavy music scene. As I mentioned, they became known as much for their music as their looks. Like those terrifying masks were everywhere on the news for a while, especially in like the early 2000s. Now Corey Taylor has a big like without the mask, without the bear. Corey Taylor has a new record. It's called CMF2. If heavy music isn't your thing, then you're like, oh god, Corey really surprised a lot of people with the diversity of genres on this record, and he talks about how when you're in a heavy band, you're genre-wise. Anyway, this record's out. It's a really lovely conversation about the expectations we place on musicians and the reality of being in a band on the public scene that's dangerous. We have a conversation with Corey Taylor. How are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm not too bad. You're in Boston.
I am indeed in Boston. I am spitting distance from Fenway, and we're hours away from rocking, like talking, you know. We'll not be doing Unchained tonight, but we'll be coming close.
All of us are trying to get close to Unchained tonight, really.
We strive for dream wears, we settle for Unchained tonight. There you go.
I want to play the first track off of the record, because as I mentioned to you before we turn the microphones on, as a traditional musician, you kind of caught me off guard. Take a listen to this.
In 500 meters, turn right onto Tower Drive.
Them off guard by starting the record that way?
No, I don't know if it was intentional, you know? I mean, for me, it's always just been about leaning into what sounds good, leaning into the songs that we want to write, you know, like the stuff that gets us excited. And when I was, you know, when I was thinking about the intro for the album, I wanted to create a mood, you know? Like, it really kind of came down, it wasn't even necessarily about the